Hello students, I am Sunny sir from Mahadi English School. This video is for students of Standard 3, Subject English. Our thought for today is, to be the best, you must be able to handle the worst. So the meaning of this thought is, if you want to become better than anyone else, what do you have to do? You should be able to be relaxed in the difficult situations. You have to keep your mind relaxed. When there is a problem, you should not panic. You should face the problem. You should use your intelligence and solve the problem, just like Tenali Rama. Now, instructions I will repeat at a glance so that you will remember it all the time. Don't tease others. Do not watch TV while eating. Take part in the physical activities. Be friendly and don't fight with others. Do your homework regularly. Don't scribble on the walls. Don't make the walls dirty. Throw the rubbish in the dustbin, not anywhere else. And don't accept the gift from the strangers. Don't take anything from the person you don't know. In our video, we will cover lesson 10 today, Tenali Rama and the three dolls. First, I will quickly give you the revision of the previous video. Then we are going to solve some interesting worksheets based on the topics that we have covered. We have covered the topics like articles, a and the, and conjunctions, joining words. Based on that, we have some worksheets. First, let us complete the textbook exercise which is pending, and then we will move ahead for solving the worksheets. So in our previous two videos, we have been solving the textual exercises of lesson 10. All these exercises we have already solved, which you can see on the screen. I'm changing the slides. We solved this exercise of articles, article A and the. Article A and article N are indefinite articles, and they are used with singular nouns. Article the is a definite article, and the is used when referring to specific people or places or things, like the sun, the Eiffel Tower, the President of India. Then we had done fill in the blanks. He is an engineer in my office. Dash play I saw yesterday was good. The play. His dream of becoming a painter came true. It is an honor to work with you. The Mona Lisa is beautiful. Then we had done this paragraph writing. Complete the paragraph. You have to write articles A and the. We have completed in the previous video. Then, we had studied about conjunctions. What are conjunctions? Conjunctions are called joining words. See, examples. But, because, and, or, for, so. All these are the joining words. And these joining words are called conjunctions. They are used for joining the sentences, for connecting the sentences. So, we had solved the exercise, this exercise based on conjunctions, the six sentences. I had marked the answer over here and you had already written it. Now, today we are going to continue with the same topic, conjunctions. Here the heading is given like this: join each pair of sentences with and, but, or, because, or so. See, these green color words are given: and, but, or, because, so. These five words you can use for joining the sentences which are given. Only these five words you are allowed to use, and therefore you have to join the sentences. So I will read the sentences one by one. Then I will read the answers which are given below, so that you can understand how to connect, how to join two sentences. If there are two small sentences, you have to join that and you have to make one big sentence. But you have to use these conjunctions for joining. Number one, I bought some cabbage, I bought some tomatoes. See, here are the two sentences. I bought some cabbage, I bought some tomatoes. So, these words are common. I bought some. See, here also it is given, and here also it is given. I bought some, I bought some. So, we can make that common. I bought some cabbages and tomatoes. I bought some cabbage and tomato. You have to combine. I have joined these two sentences. I have bought some cabbage and tomatoes. And what is the conjunction that I have used over here? I have used the conjunction and. See, we are allowed to use and. Cabbage and tomatoes. Number two. I waited for her. She did not come. I waited for her. She did not come. Here there are two opposite scenes. See, if you can notice over here, two opposite things are happening over here. Means, I was waiting, but she did not come. So, when there is opposite situation, something opposite happens. Because you were waiting and you were waiting, but the girl did not come. So, that is called contrast. And that kind of sentences we use, but. I waited for her, but she did not come. I waited for her, but she did not come. See, the conjunction but is used over here. Then, number three. Ram was practicing hard. He wanted to win the race. So, why was Ram practicing hard? What is the reason? Why was he practicing hard? The reason is that he wanted to win the race. So, he was practicing hard. Here, the conjunction used is because. See my arrow? And here in the option also it is given because. So, the answer would be like this. Ram was practicing hard because he wanted to win the race. Ram was practicing hard because he wanted to win the race. Now, why do we use the conjunction because? The conjunction because is used for giving the reason. Here the reason is given. He wanted to win the race. And for that reason, he was practicing hard. When the reason is given, you need to use because in the answer. Number four. You have to finish your homework. First sentence. You will not get to watch the cartoon if you do not finish. That is the second sentence. Again, the first sentence. You have to finish your homework. Second sentence. You will not get to watch the cartoon if you do not finish. So, I am giving you two options. The teacher is scolding you. The mother is scolding you. That if you do not finish your homework, you will not get to watch cartoon. So, you have two options. Finish your homework or you will not get to watch cartoon. When you have two options, when you have a choice, you can use the conjunction or. See, as in the given sentence, or is used over here. You have to finish your homework or you will not get to watch the cartoons. That is the sentence which we have joined. You have to finish your homework or you will not get to watch the cartoon. Next. Number 5. She wanted to serve her nation. She joined the army. So why did she join the army? She joined the army. So, with the reason of serving the nation, we have the conjunction so over here. We can use this conjunction and make the sentence like this. She wanted to serve her nation. So, she joined the army. Army means soldiers. So, the reason was that she wanted to serve the nation. So, she joined the army. The conjunction is so. You can join the sentences like this which are given. I hope you understood how to join. Next is writing part. How to write a notice. I will teach you today what is notice writing. So imagine that you are King Krishnadevarya. You have to think yourself. You have to think of yourself that you are King Krishnadevarya. Just imagine. And you want wise people from the kingdom to solve the puzzle of the three dolls. So you are King Krishnadevarya and you want the people of your town to come and help you for solving the puzzle of the three dolls. You have to write a notice and you have to invite everyone, whoever is interested, and they have to come where? At the royal court. You have to tell them together to come together at royal court, whoever is interested in solving the puzzle. You are King Krishnadevarya. Remember, what is notice? Notice is a short informative announcement. It provides all relevant information regarding what, why, where, when, etc. So notice writing means it is only very short, one paragraph writing. In that you have to give all the information. What do you want from the people? Why are you calling them? Where are you calling them? And when? At what time? So here is one sample. Let us read one example of notice. Kailash School for Excellence, Kolkata. This is the name of the school. See, notice. This is notice writing. So you have to write notice and underline. Audition for the play. Tenali Rama and the Three Dolls. What is the topic? Audition. Auditions are taken for the play Tenali Rama and the Three Dolls. For our annual day, the school has decided to stage the play Tenali Rama and the Three Dolls. Students of class 3rd and class 5th who wish to participate should assemble in the school auditorium on Wednesday at 2 p.m. For additional information, please contact Rajiv Sen, the drama teacher, Vikram Singh, secretary of theater club. This is how you write a notice. This is called notice writing. See, we can see one more example of notice writing. Now the place is different. Lotus Mahal, Hampi. Notice writing. So you'll write notice. Come to court, win your gold. This is the heading. Come to court, win your gold. The hunt is on for a person of great intelligence who will solve a puzzle that has baffled the ministers of His Majesty King Krishnadevaraya. Wise men and women are invited to assemble at the palace tomorrow evening at 6 and take up this challenge. The person who solves the puzzle will be rewarded with a bag of gold. For additional information, please contact Neelkant Somayaji, the Timarusu Prime Minister. So here is how you write notice. This is called notice writing. It will help you in future. Now let us solve the extra worksheets of the lesson. So here we have lesson number 10, Tenali Rama and the Three Dolls worksheet. And this worksheet is for your extra practice. We are going to practice grammar today in this worksheet so that you can improve your skills and you can understand the lesson in a better way. Now, first exercise that we have is compound words. You know, we have learned about compound words. So this is the exercise based on compound words. And what have we learned about compound words? A compound word is different in the meaning from the meanings of the words that make it up. So each of the words made of two smaller words are called compound words. Two smaller words, you have to join and make one compound word. So here the examples are given. You can see the two compound words are given over here. You have to write the missing word and make one compound word, right? So let us start with number one. What is the compound word? We have to read and we have to find out the compound word, which is the missing letter, which is the missing word that we will have to write. So here what's given? See, water plus dash is equal to watermelon. Water plus dash is equal to watermelon. So what should we write over here? Here the word melon is missing. So we will write the spelling of melon. M-E-L-O-N, melon. Water plus melon is equal to watermelon. Water plus melon is equal to watermelon. Number two, tooth plus dash is equal to toothbrush. Tooth plus dash is equal to toothbrush. So here we will write brush. Then our word will be complete. B-R-U-S-H, brush. Tooth plus brush is equal to toothbrush. Number three, cow plus dash is equal to cowboy. See, this is a cowboy. So cow plus dash is equal to cowboy. Here we have to write boy, B-O-Y, boy. Cow plus boy is equal to cowboy. Cow plus boy is equal to cowboy. Please do write the answer. You have to write these words in the rough book. You do not have to draw. No need of drawing. You can just write the compound words in your rough book. Number four, moon plus dash is equal to moonlight. Moon plus dash is equal to moonlight. So moon plus light, it is as simple, L-I-G-H-T. Moon plus light is equal to moonlight. See, this is moonlight. Then key plus dash is equal to keyhole. This is keyhole. So key plus hole is equal to keyhole. H-O-L-E, hole. Key plus hole is equal to keyhole. This is the hole in which you put the key and open the lock. Number six, pan plus dash is equal to pancake. Pan plus cake is equal to pancake. It's very easy. I hope you can write it yourself also. Pan plus cake is equal to pancake. So I hope you have written till number six in your rough book. Number seven, sun plus dash is equal to sunflower. So what do you add in sun to make it sunflower? You have to add flower, F-L-O-W-E-R. Sun plus flower is equal to sunflower. Number eight, rain plus dash is equal to rainbow. Rain plus dash is equal to rainbow. So rain plus bow, B-O-W. Rain plus bow is equal to rainbow. And number nine, pine plus dash is equal to pineapple. See how cute the pineapple is. I hope you have written pineapple, haven't you? So pine plus apple is equal to pineapple. What spelling do we write? A double P L E, apple. Pine plus apple is equal to pineapple. Here is the answer. Pine plus apple is equal to pineapple. So these were the nine words which are called compound words. What are they called? Compound words means each of these words are made up of the two smaller words. See, when you join these two smaller words, you can make one big word. like this. So after studying this 9, let us solve the puzzle. Here is the puzzle, right? This puzzle is in homework, means you have to solve this puzzle yourself. You can take the screenshot and you can find out all these words which are given. You have to find the words from the puzzle and you have to circle that words. Now the next exercise that we have, use each pair of pictures to write a compound word. So the pictures are given over here, two pictures are given everywhere, and we have to fill in the blanks to write the compound words. Let us read one by one and you will write this answer directly in your rough book. Number 1, cow plus boy. What does it become? Cowboy. Let us write the spelling of the same. C-O-W-B-O-Y. Cowboy. C-O-W plus B-O-Y. Cowboy. Number 2. Cup plus board. What is the spelling? What does it become? Cupboard. See, I will write the spelling. C-U-P-B-O-A-R-D. Cupboard. C-U-P-B-O-A-R-D. Cupboard. Then, star plus fish. It becomes starfish. Like this. S-T-A-R-F-I-S-H. Starfish. Star plus fish. Starfish. Then, next we have arm plus chair. It becomes armchair. The spelling will be A-R-M-C-H-A-I-R. Armchair. A-R-M-C-H-A-I-R. Armchair. Next. Earth plus worm. Earthworm. The spelling will be E-A-R-T-H W-O-R-M. Earthworm. E-A-R-T-H W-O-R-M. Earthworm. Then the last one over here is farm plus house. Farmhouse. Here is the spelling. F-A-R-M-H-O-U-S-E. Farmhouse. Farm plus house. Farmhouse. Then, next, snow plus man. Snowman. So, what will be the spelling? S-N-O-W-M-A-N. Snowman. Snow plus man. Snowman. Then, rattle plus snake. Rattlesnake. See, this is rattlesnake. So the spelling will be R-A-T-T-L-E. Rattle. S-N-A-K-E. Snake. Rattle plus snake. Rattlesnake. Next. Case plus book. Case book. Case plus book. Case book. C-A-S-E-B-O-O-K. Case book. Then the next page we have straw plus berry. It becomes strawberry. Let's write the spelling. S-T-R-A-W-B-E-R-R-Y. Strawberry. Straw plus berry. Strawberry. Then butter plus fly. What does it become? Butterfly. B-U-T-T-E-R-F-L-Y. Butterfly. Butter plus fly. Butterfly. Wild plus cat. Wild cat. See, this is wild cat. You have to be very careful. W-I-L-D-C-A-T. Wild cat. Wild plus cat. Wildcat means it is very dangerous cat. Then barn plus yard, it is barnyard. Barn plus yard, that is barnyard. BARNYARD, barnyard. Then bath plus room, bathroom. What will be the spelling? BATHROOM, bathroom. Then table plus cloth, tablecloth. See, this is tablecloth which you can put on the table for covering it. TABLE, table, CLOTH, tablecloth. Table plus cloth is equal to tablecloth. Then air plus port, airport, where the planes land, where the planes take off from. AIRPORT, airport. Air plus port, airport. So here are the compound words we solved. We wrote all the answers for all the compound words which were shown in the images. I have given this puzzle for homework. So I want to revise the question answers with you, because there are many students who make mistakes while writing the hard words. Question answers we will revise later on. First of all, I want to revise the hard words with you so that you can learn it and write one time in homework. MERCHANT, merchant. FOREIGN, foreign. PERMISSION, permission. AROUSED, aroused. IDENTICAL, identical. DIFFERENCE, difference. WORRIED, worried. Then number 8, SUMMON, summon. SOLUTION, solution. Number 10, ANNOUNCED, announced. Number 11, REPRESENTS, represents. Number 12, HARMLESS, harmless. Number 13, COURTIERS, courtiers. Number 14, IMPRESSED, impressed. Number 15, EXPLANATION, explanation. Number 16, KNOWLEDGE, knowledge. Number 17, ACKNOWLEDGE, acknowledge. Number 18, GREATNESS, greatness. Number 19, TENALIRAMA, Tenali Rama. And number 20, KRISHNADEVARAYA, Krishna Devarya. So here we complete our today's video. We solved some very interesting worksheets for compound words, and we also revised the hard words. Thank you for watching the video, and have a wonderful day.